Yeah, I was holding my breath because you never know what Marietta is going to say about you. But she was very kind. So, thank you very much. I like Charlie, I will dispense with the usual greetings. I just want to see whether my presentation is alive. My assignment follows very well from the quite profound and fundamental philosophical theological foundations on the idea of subsidiarity that Father Murray has presented. This was fascinating. I think one of the things that you will note is that the principle of subsidiarity can be picked up by different paradigms. It can be picked up by business to support a form of corporate organization, which is particularly now with the modern IT technology, businesses flattened its organizations, and it is much less based on hierarchical structures. It is more founded on networking, but it can also be used to justify a very atomistic view of society, to justify a focus on the individual persons as the main actors of society. In my presentation, I would like to emphasize the fact that while when we talk of subsidiarity, we focus on the inhibition against the higher authorities and the higher organizations intervening inappropriately with the lower and giving the benefit of the doubt for action and agency to the lower organizations. But as I will point out, it is very important to view at the lowest organizations and to focus on how they achieve the degree of autonomy, the degree of power, the degree of self-reliance that is important for them to be active as agents. And this my focus will be on process rather than structure. And I'd like to set the subsidiarity principle within the Philippine realities, as it were, to give it, as Shakespeare says, a local habitation and a name. Now let me just see if this is working right. Okay. This serves as sort of an outline. My focus will be on process. The whole process of translating, am I blocking the way? Let me sit down. The process of subsidiarity as a process. Set it within the context of the historical evolution of the opposite of subsidiarity, what Philip Camara calls superiority, that is really the mark of governance and action in the Philippines. The principle of pinatulo rather than pinatubo, superiority rather than subsidiarity. How did the Philippines get to where it is right now? So I'd like to talk about that briefly. How we developed, for example, what we call the unitary system rather than the federal system. But I'd like to also say that when I say federal, I'd like to detach it from the way the federal system is being used in current discourse here and the purposes for which it is being advocated. Third, I want to look at the rise of localization and self-reliance as ideas in the Philippine community, in the Philippine Republic. And finally, to look at the process of confederation and sustainability. I'd like to emphasize sustainability because the Philippines has become famous for many things in the world. It's been famous for being one of the most, perhaps the most corrupt country in the world. We have all sorts of claims to fame. We are also perhaps the best representative of what could happen to the world, to the planet, if we apply, continue to apply the paradigm for development that we have been using in the present trend towards a globalization of enterprises on the planet. All right, so those are the topics I'd like to cover, and I'll go over it rather quickly. Let me just go over certain concepts that are useful. First, I'm going to emphasize the process of achieving self-reliance, because that has already been embodied in jurisprudence in the Philippines. The concept of self-reliance has been used in some of our constitutions and is certainly embodied in the local government code. Subsidium, the Latin term, is a military term referring to a reserve unit, and emphasizes the fact that the reserve unit is reserved in the sense that it is called to action only if the deployed unit cannot do its job adequately with its current resources, with its deployed resources. So that is a very important concept. That's where the term subsidiarity comes from. So the important thing, however, when you focus on this term, is to how do you maximize the capacity of the deployed unit? How do you enhance that capacity so that it achieves its full capability as a deployed unit? So again, I'm not focusing on the inhibition against the reserve unit to intervene inappropriately. I'm focusing on what it takes to bring to the full potential the powers and the capacities of the deployed unit. I mean, that is the focus that I'd like to. Fidus is the Latin term, is really an agreement among autonomous entities. Again, I'd like to emphasize the fact that the degree of autonomy of the negotiating entities is very important for the power of the fidus, the federatus. And I recall Charlie referred to this subsidiarity movement as being, as it were, in its early stirrings as a fetus. So the important thing about the fetus is that from fetus it must achieve its full potential. So the fetus as fetus must become fully mature in order for subsidiarity to be effective. And the federatus is the confederation. Again, looking at that as a process, the process of forming the confederations. That's going to be a very important process in the Philippines particularly, because the perfection of that fetus depends on the degree of autonomy that's achieved by the negotiating units. If the negotiating unit has not achieved its full autonomy or its full potential, then there is no level playing field, and the process of confederation involves a lot of dependency on the part of the units confederating, so that there's a strong element, residual element of superiority and not yet a full subsidiarity principle. So those are the concepts you want to play with in the present discussion. And the goal we're looking at is how do you achieve maximum self-reliance as called for in our constitution. Federalism cannot be imposed. It must be evolved, and we must emphasize and perfect the wholeness of the part before really emphasizing the partness nature of the part. Enhancing the capacity of the smallest units. In that process, the question is asked then, as I said, it, subsidiarity can be used to justify the power of the individual in an atomistic view. The point is, the individual cannot be sustainable. I mean, Father Murray's reference to Aristotle is very appropriate here. That man is a political, not only political, social animal.